long as we're talking about stupid shit on social media. That's my segue. Don't blame me. Where is it? Here we go. Little bit of news. Little bit of news. Breaking current news right now on Twitter. Apparently, Dan Schneider is in for a little bit of a rough ride. I know I've covered Epstein quite a bit. I'm fascinated with that. In fact, he's going into court again today on the 31st. People are speculating the reason he tried to kill himself, quote unquote, is because he was served with a particular lawsuit from another victim, and that maybe there's something about this particular person that really scares the shit out of him, and that's why he tried to off himself. Though I find it very odd that his cellmate, a guy convicted of killing four people and an ex-cop, happened to have an illegal cell phone on him the day before this all took place. Makes me a little suspicious. But who knows how that's going to break. But anyway, Epstein's going into court again today. They're going to try to get him out of federal lockup. I don't think the judge is going to give a shit. I think the judge thinks it's funny. And he should, because fuck Epstein. Claims he's a billionaire. Not a billionaire. But a very rich man who's never spent any time in a shitty, dingy cell. Probably really fucking with his head. So with Epstein in the news, and you know everybody talking about it, I mean, fuck, we had... who was the guy from American Beauty? Kevin Spacey. We had Kevin Spacey. His lawsuit got dismissed on the charges of telling people to grab his dick in public. Or whatever weird shit he was up to. So lots of talk about sexual misconduct and pedophilia, but there's one name. There's one name that's always protected. He's the man with the party van. I'm talking about our good boy Dan. Dan Schneider. The OG when it comes to rumors in Hollywood and television. For some reason, this guy's like a Teflon Don. Nothing can stick to him. All his former starlets can go crazy, put up videos of them acting like they're insane. Name dropping him doesn't matter. He can make 1,000 little girls rub their feet in his face. People just applaud it and like, oh my God, that's so original. Way to go, Nickelodeon. So, like, Dan somehow always slips through the net. He always seems to escape it. But apparently, that might be coming to an end. Because one of the former Disney starlets or Nickelodeon starlets or former stars is starting to drop hints that maybe they're going to be talking about some big stuff. And maybe it relates to Dan Schneider. And wait till you see the amount of traction this gained. From this particular tweet, this is from July 30th, so just yesterday. Nicole from Zoe 101. I'm shook she's really exposing Dan Schneider. 500,000 views. Just think about that for a minute. It's reached the point where everybody suspects Dan Schneider is some weird fucking sex offender. They're just normal people are talking about it. They're like aware of it. If you bring up Dan Schneider, people are going to be like, oh yeah, the foot guy. Oh yeah, that's the guy that stalks little girls' feet on the studio lot. I know what you're talking about. So this is the video. Let's give it a listen. Oh, it's a tweet or a Instagram post, I'm guessing, from the Zoe 101 star. Why am I left out? Lol, it's kind of hilarious now. We are like 30 years old. Wow. Yes, they weren't invited to the reunion party.
I shouldn't be crying because I'm an adult and those things were so long ago, but I guess it just brought up old memories and it's just sad. I don't get it.
Then they followed up with this post. This is for every woman who ever felt left out. Every woman who ever felt lonely. You are not alone. This is a world of women out there waiting to love you. Okay, I'm going to make a video letting you all know my experience of being Nicole on Zoe 101. Oh, somebody post the picture of Dan Schneider sweating nervously. Stay tuned. I think it's important now, more than ever, to speak out. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Oh, Dan, time to leave the country. This Zoe 101 reboot is triggering a lot of childhood trauma.
Listen, I don't think it's fair to tell anybody how they should feel when they're dealing with childhood trauma triggers. So please be nice during this time. Thank you.
So, a former starlet who worked on one of the main shows that Dan was running, producing, directing, whatever. The same show, by the way. Zoe 101 is where the rumors came about that Britney Spears' little sister, Jamie Lynn Spears, was actually impregnated by Dan Schneider. That was a rumor circulating on those. There's a certain website that talks about gossip, and that kept getting brought up, that Dan Schneider knocked up Jamie Lynn Spears, and they paid off some kid to pretend it was a father to avoid a scandal. So now here's a co-star from that show who's suddenly talking about being emotional and childhood trauma, and they keep bringing up Dan Schneider. Oh, boy. Dan Schneider, by the way, was recently fired. You know, he had like a aura of protection around him because he was a hit maker. He could create a show that would get 10, 20 million, and then through syndication, even more money. Just ridiculous amounts of money for Nick and Disney and whoever he worked for. But he got fired. He got fired for being unprofessional on set and mistreating people. So that aura of protection doesn't exist anymore. So when you start to get former starlets coming out and saying, I want to talk about my childhood trauma from the set, and it's important for women to speak out, are we about to see Dan Schneider get Me Too'd? Is Dan Schneider about to get Weinsteined? I mean, is it finally happening? Is it possible? Everybody's been waiting for years to see that happen. And the fact that it just comes out of left field? I don't know. I don't know, chat. You tell me. You tell me, do you think our boy Dan here is in for a tough time? Oh, I see some Fs in chat. If the stream dropped out on you, just hit F5 to refresh. Occasionally it drops out. I guess Dan and Nickelodeon don't want us talking about this. Uh-oh. I'm seeing Fs and I don't know why. Are we hitting F for poor Nicole? You think she's going to have a tragic accident, chat? Is Nicole going to pull a Lena and take a header off an 80-story building? Is that maybe where this is going? You know, this makes me want to take a look at just weird Dan Schneider shit that it just exists out there. In fact, what happens if you just search his name? Like, if we just search his name. Okay, I want to see if I can show you the search results. Will this show up? All right, seriously, this is what comes up. Oh, I don't even know if it's going to go that high. Maybe I can't show you this. Oh, no, it's not going to do it. When I enter Dan, if you go on YouTube and enter Dan Schneider, the first thing that, you can see it. There you go. See, I'm spelling Dan Schneider. Look at the first two results, foot and feet. You can't even look up his name without immediately going to what they know he does. It's like the worst kept secret. Oh, yeah, look at this. 2.1 million views talking about Dan Schneider. Groomed for success, a Dan Schneider story. Created by Dan Schneider. I bet this is going to be one of these. You know, let's take a look at this. I think this is the weird highlight reel that shows all the fucked up shit that Dan does. This is Dan Schneider's writing, folks. Duh. See if you notice like a common theme.
After this, we massage my feet.
No, gross. Come on, work the heel, rub it like a man.
David, I hired him to read the book to me.
Welcome to Nickelodeon, kids. Oh, you want to be a star, do you? Take your shoes off, kid.
Yeah, there.
Sam?
Surprise party.
Sam? Wake up! Just leave it all to me.
Hey, I'll show you. I can't believe I'm doing this.
It's amazing to me that Schneider has done this for like decades. For decades he's done this. All the stories that circulate, if you look his name up, the first thing is feet. That's the first result. It's like the worst kept secret in Hollywood.
Okay, on three, I'm gonna...
Just do it!
Alright. There we go. Spread your toes, girl.
Hold big toe in your mouth,
check this out.
Who wants to be a star? Welcome to Hollywood. I'm Dan Schneider. I want you to suck on your toes. That's funny. The kids like it. Now just look at the camera and say, they taste tasty, Dan. we're testing out angles and lights. This won't air on television. Just look at me. Look at me and eat the toe. Eat the toe for Dan Schneider. Oh, I think that's Jamie Lynn Spears. I think that's the one that everybody alleges he knocked up. Have you noticed the trend with Dan Schneider shows? I don't know. It's hard to pick a common theme. What could Dan Schneider be up to? So many things happening. It's hard to keep track. God, was he the one that came out with the Cuck show? Bella and the Bulldogs? It's just, what's that? Actually, I want to see if that was Dan Schneider, too. Hold on. Yeah, because I think Bella and the Bulldogs was a story about a little white girl joining an all-black football team that was named the Bulls. Just no subtlety, Nickelodeon. Oh my God, it's on 4 seasons now. Season number 4 already. I don't see any pictures of anybody sucking their toes, so I don't think Dan Schneider was a part of this particular production. Oh. Oh, Dan. Dan Schneider, what are you doing? I'm sorry. I'm getting sidetracked just by the Dan Schneider shit. It's hard. Everybody knows. It's amazing. It looks like Shane Dawson did one with 10 million views from a year ago. Holy shit. Oh, what was the... chat, maybe somebody can link this to me. Was one of his former stars losing their shit on like an Instagram video? And like freaking out and crying and had fucked up makeup on, looked like the Joker. And they kept saying, "This is your fault, Dan." I don't know what show they were from. iCarly or one of the fucking ones that he did. See if I can find that clip. Oh, there's so many. Oh, here's one. Somebody got his Twitter account. Let's take a look at Dan Schneider's Twitter account. This guy, I did a video on it. Dan Schneider's
Twitter. What's everybody, Hoover? Today I'm going to be talking about Dan, but I like your foot choice even.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Dan Schneider, this is how unsubtle he is about his fetish and targeting children. He would just randomly Photoshop feet onto little girls. Like, this is a picture from his Twitter account. He just Photoshops feet on their head. That's so weird.
Better. Dude, what the fuck? Okay, no. I hate this.
Let's see if we can find
fucking retweets. This toe belongs to one of the...
Oh, Dan, you're just not subtle at all. At least this has it organized. Let's see. Again, Dan Schneider. Toes similar to fingers, but not nearly as good. Who agrees? Oh, Dan, trying to... A little subterfuge. Would you like to see Victoria Justice pour ketchup all over her feet? Well, here you go. Links to the clip. Yeah, Dan, that's what everybody was waiting for. That particular pick. Carly tickles Sam's very unusual toes. If you have a moment, will you please name Sam's toes for us? This fucking guy. Here's Dan Schneider on Facebook. Who wants to see Jenny McCurdy's toes? I got plenty of picks to go around if you tune into the new iCarly episode. I balls this Friday on Nick. This fucking dude. Just no shame. Dan Schneider has no shame. Oh, I can't imagine the amount of fucking Nickelodeon stars. All these videos are all talking about it. Some of these videos have 10 million views. There's no getting around it anymore.
In 5.
Here's another video. Let's take a look at this one. And then we'll
we'll move on. I just found it interesting. This one is called Dan Loves Feet with 100,000 fucking views.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
Because I will tase her.
Holy shit, forget Epstein. I think we found the real problem here, chat. I think we know what's going on that on those children's TV lots. Oof. Ken Ashcourt, press F for Dan Soul Brother Schneider. You know, I always prefer Dan, I'm going to skeet, skeet, skeet on your feet, Schneider. But, you know, whatever. He's got plenty of nicknames.
This was the image capture they sent. Let me see if I can move this over a little bit, get this good here. So apparently it's make sure I get the fucking name right. Where is it? Bell and the Bulls. So it's some kids, it's some kids show, right? And it's about a strong independent woman who's the quarterback of the football team, and she's got I don't even know how to fucking explain this or how to start this. All right, so Bell and the Bulls, kids show. Strong, independent girl who's the quarterback, and she's got her cuck, and she's got a black bull. Now, you'd think that's a joke. When I got sent this, I thought they were fucking around. This is actually legitimate, and I have a copy of the video this guy made to show you what's going on. So, this is produced by a guy named Jonathan Butler. So, I'm going to show you his IMDb page. Just take a minute and see if you notice anything. This is a guy that produced this kid show for, not Disney, I'm sorry, Nickelodeon, Bell and the Bulldogs. Do you notice anything in particular? Anything popping out at you? Because that popped out at me pretty fucking quickly. it gets better, though. I was reading the fucking Amazon customer reviews for The Cuckold, the video that he made. A lot of disappointed people. I'll get to that in a minute, though. But yeah, he made this in 2009. It's a movie about cuckolding. And now he's taken it to the next level. He's not satisfied just making movies for adults. He's making shows for children about cuckolding. As the image capture goes on to explain, he's got a co-producer. Where was this guy's name? Oh, this is great. Oh, Garza. A Jewish name. And of course, obviously, people were digging through to see what the numbers are for the Jewish character. He's got 27 on. So what is that? And they're looking into it. And 27. Holocaust Remembrance Day. So this is fantastic no matter how you look at it. But I wanted to show you the video, because I think it really adds to it. So I've got this queued up. Show you the amazing work this gentleman has been doing for our children. Okay, make sure that's good. Get everything else set up here. Oh, see, it fucked it already. Whatever. You know what? Doesn't matter. Does not matter. Why are you doing that to me? Yeah, whatever. All right, enjoy. You're gonna like this.
Hey, yo. White boys, let me holler at you a minute. And relax, this ain't another nigga trying to stomp his sour grapes in a black wine, bitching and moaning about the evil white man. On the contrary, where I'm from, we say real recognizes real.
Y'all know the expression, love is war. Untrue. Making love is war. and the Black Bulls were Spartans.
So allow me to be the first nigga in history to recognize. Say congratulations on the whole, you know, world domination thing.
Sex is hunger for us. And if we can't find lobster and caviar, we'll grab a quick taco.
You think you're the first housewife whose husband got blown on a Friday night? Get in line.
Behind you.
This gets me to thinking. It's true what they say. What goes round comes round. There's an ebb and a flow, you know? You reap what you sow.
The party's on, bitch. Come. You don't have to do anything you don't want to, or you can do everything you want to.
I'll think about it.
That's more like it.
So I'm wondering, and white boys, if you're smart, you are too. What's the signs you're losing your dominance? Or put another way, how you know if you're on your way up or down?
I've been talking to some of the girls. They're getting hungry.
I thought I was a dark secret.
What other kind of secret could you be?
Tell me about these white girls.
Imagine this. MILFs in their 30s and 40s. This thing see it to believe it type shit. And the icing, their husbands know.
Some of that up?
Nah. This is a dish best served cold.
You mean like revenge?
I mean like sushi.
I hope you were enjoying that. That's a fantastic trailer from Jonathan Butler. Now, when you go to check out his reviews for this movie, it gets even better. Let's switch over. Let's go take a look at his reviews for The Cuckold. Oh shit, wrong thing. There we go. They're not nobody's happy with the reviews of this thing, which is remarkable. I think this might be a metacuck, to be honest with you, because nobody's getting like there's no sex in it, and that seems to be what a lot of people were hoping for based on the horrible looking cover. So they're all disappointed. They didn't get what they were looking for. And the people that were looking for a good movie got fucked because this is just shit. This is a terrible fucking movie. So he's effectively meta-cucked the audience into his shitty fucking product. It's pretty great. But yeah, so this guy is making kid shows for Nickelodeon. How great is that? Everybody loves those Nickelodeon shows. Hey yo, I'm gonna fuck your woman. Thank you, Mr. Butler. That is fantastic. It's taking cucking into a new era. It's, yeah, Nickelodeon. Nickelodeon? Give me, I don't know how you'd fucking put those two together. I can't even put them together. Nick Juice? That'll work. That'll do. But yeah, this is a show that Nickelodeon's going to run. I wonder what other amazing things he's going to put out there. Because when you... Actually, I should show you what this looks like. Let me, you know, I'm going to back this up. Because you have to see the art for this fucking shit thing. Oh, where is it? Oh, yeah, here we go. So you've got, like, this 8-foot-tall Jew who's wearing the number 27, who I don't know what kind of growth hormones they're giving him, but he's obviously way too tall for his own good. Then you got the black guy just smiling with his hand around her because he's fucking the shit out of that. And then you've got probably the world's tiniest person. I don't know what kind of birth defect led to this, but he must be under 3 feet tall. And he's number 99. That's how many guys away he is from ever fucking her. He's 99 dudes away from getting a chance at... Yeah, it's Manly Tears. Manly Tears has been cast in a Nickelodeon show. They're going to give him a fucking footstool so the camera can catch his head for most of the scenes. If he's lucky. Maybe they can get a special swoop crane to go down low enough to catch that. I don't know. But just look at this ridiculous shit. Let me, you know what? I had some other things queued up, but I'm just going to fucking go like this. Bell and the Bulldogs. Let's take a look at this amazing shit. Let's look at the great acting.
and Bella and the Bulldogs.
The cast of the brand new series Bella and the Bulldogs is letting you in on who's bringing the laughs.
Who's bringing
We're
the
all
laughs?
Funny in our own weird ways. Like, yeah. Every character is funny, but differently.
This is not cute.
When we watch the show, there's not one character who you watch and you're like, oh, they're not as funny as anybody else. We all have our own different type
Everybody's
of
Everybody's different. Everybody brings something to the show.
Everybody's different. It's so multicultural. Isn't it great? We've got a manlet, a Jew, an Asian girl, and a black guy fucking everybody. It's just, it's diversity in action.
Get away from me, tiny man. Everyone has their own part that completes the whole thing.
Yeah, you do that, blabberback.
Oh, see, the cuck stepped out of line. That was a mistake.
Way too far.
I'd say Buddy's pretty funny, though.
Yeah. Ah, my leg! Buddy makes me laugh
all the time.
Yeah. YOLO, am I right?
Almost all of our characters have their own punchlines.
Oh, yeah.
And Buddy is that punchline. The manlet is the punchline for this entire show.
Yeah.
No. No, I cannot.
Sausage and biscuits!
Oh, no, you didn't!
What's yours, Buddy?
Yeah, Buddy.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Do a performance right now.
Who said that? Who said that? Hey, who said that?
Who said that?
Holy shit. So this is children's programming.
Bella has a few that she does.
Oh, come on.
I don't want to show.
Do it. There's one.
Okay. She says, like, Shabuya!
Don't miss Bella and the Bulldogs every Saturday.
You're right. It's Bella and the Bulls. That is what this show is. I love the fact this guy gets away with it. He has gotten away with it. It's really pretty fucking brilliant when you think about it. Yeah, window capture 2. It's always a bitch for some reason. I have no idea why. Just does not want to deal with it. Subregion error. Let's see if we get this shit working properly. There we go. Should work. If I had a dual monitor set up, this would probably be easier. A stream within a stream, yes. See, I set it up well. You get double the bang for the buck. In this case, a black buck. Because that's what Bella's banging. Sure isn't shit, that little manlet who's running around. Oh, and everybody likes jokes, and they all look at him. They look at the tiny little gay white guy. Because, you know, they're just riding his ass. This is a show on the air, yeah. Bella and the Bulldogs not only had one season, they've got another season. They've been renewed. Jonathan King Cuck Butler has worked out a deal with Nickelodeon where he is going to run a second season of this. I have no idea how that happened, but he somehow has pulled this off. So Bella and the Bulldogs, it's going to be on Nickelodeon. It's been renewed. You're gonna love it. It's going to be great. He's 4'4". Is that an accurate measurement? I didn't know they made people that small. Maybe Jonathan Butler keeps him in the trunk of the car and pulls him out every time he needs, you know, the quintessential cuck. I can't believe it's mainstream. I saw that fucking, you know, somebody sent me the links and stuff, and I thought it was bullshit, and then I looked into it, and it's completely true. There's nothing about this that's made up. This guy really does make these fucking movies, and he's responsible for kids' programming. And when you look at the subject matter of the shows, that's what it is. Oh, let's see. I thought I had another thing queued up with this guy. Let me see if I can find it. See if I find another great clip. Oh, should we hear the official theme song? Please tell me it has to do with cuckoldry. We'll find a way.
This is gonna be awesome! Woo! You won't find me in the bleachers. I'm made of spice and sugar. And add a little glitter. And you get a game changer.
Strong, independent woman who don't need no man. I hope you're enjoying it, chat. Enjoy this. Lefty pull found a way. This is their show, isn't it? every Saturday. Fucking episodes every Saturday. So kids won't miss it. There's no way for them to miss it. They're going to make sure they're going to watch it. Fantastic. Welcome to the future of fucking Nickelodeon. You know, when I was a kid, kids' shows were fucking cartoons. Or maybe you'd have, I don't know, once in a while some shitty drama, but this is some next level stuff. This is just amazing. It's amazing.